Hi friends, myself Venugopal, I am physics faculty. Today we are going to be deal waves topic. The first question is the equation y is equals to 4 sine pi of 200t minus x by 25 represents a transverse wave that travels in a stretched wire where x comma y are in centimeters and t in second. Its wavelength and velocities are option A 0.5 meter and 25 meter per second, option B 0.5 meter and 50 meter per second, option C 1 meter and 50 meter per second, option D 1 meter and 25 meter per second. Which is the correct option? Wavelength formula, lambda is equals to 2 pi by k, you can write. And velocity v equals to n lambda, you can write. N means omega by 2 pi, you can write, into lambda. Now the given equation is given y is equals to 4 sine pi of 200 t minus x by 25. They given. So now this is then the form of y equals to a sine of, take the pi inside, omega t minus kx, like that it will be. If you take pi inside, therefore you can compare a is equals to 4 and next omega t means 200 pi t. So means omega is equals to 200 pi and next kx means pi into x by 5, means k is equal to pi by 25, you can take. Now take the values over here, lambda is equal to 2 pi by k value. What is meant by k? It's a pi by 25. Bring upside, 25 to 0, 50, pi pi get cancelled. So lambda value we got 50 centimeters, means 0.5 meters lambda. And next second value v equals to 2 omega by 2 pi into lambda, means omega value 200 pi by 2 into pi into lambda value 0.5 meters. So pi get cancelled, 2 ones are 200s, that is equals to 0.5 into 100 gives 50 meter per second. So lambda value we got it as 0.5 centimeter and velocity we got it as 50 meter per second. So which option is the correct? Option B is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? The frequency of a fork is 500 Hz. Velocity of sound in air is 350 meter per second. The distance through which sound travel by the time that fork makes 125 vibrations is option A 87.5 meters, option B 700 meters, option C 1400 meters, option D 1.75 meter. Which is the correct option? X is equals to, distance traveled is equals to n lambda. So now here n lambda means n into lambda means v by small n. Now given small n is equals to 500 hertz frequency, number of vibrations it is doing 125 vibrations, velocity of sound is 350 meter per second. So now take x is equal to 125 into 350 by 500, you can take it. So 0, 0 get cancelled. So now 5 tens are 50 and 5 sevens are 35. And next 12.5 into 7 you can take. By multiplying this, we will get 87.5 meters. So that it will, the sound will travel for a distance 87.5 meters. Which option is the correct one? Option A is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? The velocity of a transverse wave in a stretched wire is 100 meter per second. If the length of wire is doubled and tension in the string is also doubled, the final velocity of the transverse wave in the wire is option A 100 meter per second, option B 141.4 meter per second, option C 200 meter per second, option D 282.8 meter per second. Which is the correct option? How to solve this question? T2 is equals to 2T1 they given, and velocity they given as V1 is equals to 100 meter per second, and they are asking V2 value. So V is directly proportional to root T. We know that, all of you. So V2 by V1 is equals to root over T2 by T1 you can take. So V2 is equal to V1 into root over T2 value, T2 by T1 value, it's a 2. Now 100 into root 2, that is equals to 100 into 1.414. By multiplying, it will comes 141.4 meter per second is the velocity. V2 value 141.4 meter per second. Which is the correct option? Option B is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? If the length of a stretched string is shortened by 40% and the tension is increased by 44%, then the ratio of the final and initial fundamental frequencies is option A 2:1, option B 3:2, option C 3:4, option D 1:3. Which is the correct option? The frequencies is directly proportional to square root of its temperature and inversely proportional to its length. Therefore, N2 by N1 is taken as L1 by L2 into root over T2 by T1 you can consider. They are asking final frequency and initial frequency ratio. Now, take it. What you told in the question? Length is decreasing 40% and tension is increasing 44%. That means L2 is equal to L1 minus 40%, means 40 by 100 L1. That is equals to 60 by 100 L1 you can take. Therefore L2 is equals to 6 by 10 L1. Means L1 by L2 is equals to 10 by 6 you can be considered. And next, tensions. T2 is equal to T1 plus 44% increasing, means 44 by 100 into T1 you can take. Therefore 144 by 100 into T1. Therefore T2 by T1 they are asking, that is equals to 144 by 100. Take those values and substitute. Therefore 10 by 6 will be the L1 by L2 ratio, and root over T2 by T1 value 144 by 100. Take out from the root. 12 12s are 144, 10 10s are 100. If it is coming out, 10 by 6 into 12 by 10. Therefore, 10 10 get cancelled, 6 1s are 6 2s are. Therefore, 2 by 1 is the ratio. So, N2 is to N1 is equals to 2:1 is the ratio. Which is the correct option? Option A is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? The pressure of air increases by 100 millimeters of Hg and the temperature decreases by 1 degree centigrade. The change in the speed of sound in air at STP is option A 61 meter per second, option B 61 millimeter per second, option C 61 centimeter per second, option D 0.61 centimeter per second. Which is the correct option? At STP conditions, velocity of sound is taken as 336 meter per second we can be consider, and temperature is considered as 273 Kelvin. Now here the value change in temperature is given as 1 degree centigrade. So change in temperature means 1 degree centigrade or 1 degree 1 Kelvin also we can take. No bother about that. Now they are asking change in velocity of sound. So now V is proportional to root temperature. Now if you take V is proportional to t power half. So by taking error formula, which we know in the units and dimensions topic, so change in velocity by original velocity is equals to half, you can take front, change in temperature by original temperature, you can take it. Now change in velocity v is equals to v by 2 into delta t by t. Now v value 336 meter per second by 2 into delta t value 1 by t value 273 Kelvin. So now 2 1s are 2 6s are 2 8s are. So now 168 by 273, by simplifying this value we will get 0.61, we will get it. So now 0.61 meter per second. Now change in velocity is equal to 61 centimeter per second. Which option is the correct? Option C is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? A cylindrical resonance tube open at both ends has a fundamental frequency f in air. If half of the length is dipped vertically in water, the fundamental frequency of the air column will be option A, f by 2, option B, f, option C, 3f by 2, option D, 2f. Which is the correct option? How to solve this question? Frequency of open pipe, N open is equals to V by 2L you can take. And frequency of closed pipe, N closed is equal to V by 4L dash. So here in open pipe length you can consider is L equal to capital L only. Closed pipe L dash equal to L by 2. Means half of the length of the pipe is dipped in water. That's why L dash you can take L by 2. Now open pipe and closed pipe. Open pipe value they are given as F. What about closed pipe? V by 4. L dash means L by 2 you can take. So 2 1s are 2 2s are, that is equal to V by 2 L only coming. So V by 2 L value it's a F. So this is also F. Therefore N open, if they give F, then N closed also F is the frequency. So which option is the correct one? Option B is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? Two argon open pipes of lengths 50 cm and 51 cm produce 6 beats per second. Then the speed of sound is nearly option A 300 meter per second, option B 306 meter per second, option C 303 meter per second, option D 350 meter per second. Which is the correct option? Beats formula, delta N is equal to N1 minus N2 or N2 minus N1 we can take it. Now both are open pipes. N1 is equal to V by 2L1 and N2 is equal to V by 2L2. You can be consider. Now here N, delta N value is given as 6 beats per second. Therefore N1 6 is equal to V by 2L1 minus V by 2L2. Now the given lengths L1 is equal to 50 centimeter and L2 is equal to 51 centimeters. So now 6 is equal to V by 2 into 1 by 50 minus 1 by 51. So now simplify this. So 12 is equal to V into, so by taking LCM of this value you will get, so 51 minus 50 by 51 into 50. So now that it is V is equal to 12 by, so 0.35 it will come. By simplifying this value we will get it's a 306 meter per second approximately. So which is the correct option? Option B is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? A sonometer has 25 forks. each produces four beats with the next one. If the maximum frequency is 288 Hz, which is the frequency of last fork, the lowest frequency is option A 72 Hz, option B 96 Hz, option C 128 Hz, option D 192 Hz. Which is the correct option? Given number of beats, delta N is equals to 4 beats it is producing. And next, number of tuning forks are nothing but 25 forks. And last one frequency is given as 288 Hz. And next, first frequency they are asking. Now, frequency difference N2 minus N1 is equal to N capital N minus 1 into each beat frequency. Now 288 minus N1 is equal to 25 minus 1 into 4 gives 24 into 4. So 288 minus N1 is equal to 24 into 4. So now N1 is equal to 288 minus 24 fours are 96. So 288 minus 96 gives 192. So N1 is equal to 192 Hz. The first tuning fork frequency is 192 Hz, it is the lowest, and last tuning fork frequency they are given 288 Hz. So which is the correct option? Option D is the correct answer. Shall we go to next question? An observer moves towards a stationary source of sound with a velocity 1/5 of the velocity of sound. The percentage increase in the apparent frequency is option A 5%, option B 20%, option C 0%, option D 0.5%. Which is the correct option? Here, observer is approaching towards the source. Therefore, apparent frequency is equal to original frequency into velocity of sound plus velocity of observer by velocity of sound. Now, velocity of observer is given as 1 by 5 times of the velocity of sound. Now, N dash by N, bring this side, is equal to V plus V by 5 whole by V. Now, by making LCM, 6V by 5V, that is equals to 6 by 5. Now, they are asking percentage change means N dash by N minus 1 whole into 100 we want. That is equal to 6 by 5 minus 1 whole into 100. That is equal to 1 by 5 into 100. That is equal to 20%. So, which is the correct option? Option B is the correct answer. Okay, students. By ending of every episode, we are going to be asked one question for the students. The student question is, a truck blowing horn of frequency 500 Hz travels towards a vertical mountain and a driver hears echo of frequency 600 Hz. If velocity of sound in air is 340 meter per second, then speed of the truck is option A 31 meter per second, option B 41 meter per second, option C 51 meter per second, option D 21 meter per second. You can send your correct answers in the format srdg-phy-13, your option. Send that SMS to 888-44-86-915. The first three students who are sending correct SMS can get a beautiful prizes. Okay, students, today we discussed waves topic. In the next episode, we will discuss new topic. Thank you.
Vidyadayini Residential School, KR Nagar, Harihar. Admissions open from nursery to 10th CBSE syllabus. Shrimati Radhabai D. Gopal Rao PU College. Admissions open for PUC Science and Commerce. And Vidyadayini Degree College. Admissions open for BCom and BA. Contact today 9448115118.